Thanks for the wonderful presentations. I think they were quite enlightening and quite heartening. Now I'll request all my fellow panel members to, you know, share their thoughts on what they saw and what they think can be, you know, the tips that they may want to share with the participants on how, you know, how to move forward in this. So probably if each one of you can share a few lines. We do this first and then we throw open for a few question answers. So we have 10 minutes, so just request each of you to take one and a half minutes so that we have some time left for question answers as well.
These were wonderful presentations and bada acha laga ye grassroots pe jo kaam dekhkar aur teen char presentation to aisi lagi jo shayad jis scale pe hum log kaam kar rahe usme bhi hame badi madad mil sakti hai, so it will be a learning for us as well and very exciting work happening. Broadly, I think if we look at different presentations being made, so what is coming clear ki jisme objective clear tha ki aap social media ke through kya karna chahte hain aur jisme strategy clear thi, these presentations you could see real impact. And jisme shayad ek kyunki social media pe aapko presence dikhani hai aur uske liye aap social media par ho to wahan par shayad impact ki to baat nahi ho rahi hai. हो सकता है आपने थोड़ी सी ब्रांड बिल्डिंग एक्सरसाइज की हो, थोड़ी सी अवेयरनेस की हो. देर आर सेवरल वेज टू कनेक्ट एंड सेवरल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स टू बी कनेक्टेड ऑन सोशल मीडिया. तो वो अपने ध्यान में अगर रख के हम स्ट्रेटजी अपनी बनाएं, ब्रांड का हो सकता है, शेयरिंग बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस का हो सकता है, फंड रेजिंग का हो सकता है, एडवोकेसी का हो सकता है, थॉट लीडरशिप के लिए हो सकता है, डायरेक्ट एक्शन के लिए हो सकता है. जैसे आपने एक एग्रीकल्चर से रिलेटेड आपने प्रेजेंटेशन देखी, डिज़ास्टर से रिलेटेड आपने एक प्रेजेंटेशन देखी, डाटा के लिए प्रेजेंटेशन, डाटा एक ऑब्जेक्टिव हो सकता है. सिमिलरली मॉनिटरिंग एक ऑब्जेक्टिव हो सकता है. आपने एक दो प्रोग्राम प्रेजेंटेशन देखी जिसमें हेल्थ से रिलेटेड या रूरल लाइवलीहुड से रिलेटेड वर्क था, वो हाउ टू इंटीग्रेट डिफरेंट टूल्स ऑफ डिजिटाइजेशन, डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ सोशल मीडिया टू बी एबल टू कनेक्ट. सो आई थिंक दैट बी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. और जहाँ पर भी आपने देखा कि कॉल फॉर एक्शन थी या जहाँ पर कंटेंट एंगेजिंग था, वहाँ पर आपको लगा इम्पैक्ट भी हो रहा है और रीच भी बढ़ रही है. सो राइट नाउ आई विल रिजर्व माय कमेंट्स टू दिस. थैंक यू.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू कंग्रेचुलेट ऑल द प्रेजेंटर्स. इट वाज अ वेरी इंस्पायरिंग एंड quite a forward looking presentations. It's good. I think the couple of this is important that the while we use various social media and the one of the key information is also how do we share the impact. That is going to be quite crucial. We do give lot of information. One advantage, both the desired challenges also, is too much of information. So how do we process that information, whatever that data that is coming. But the more impactful stories if you share, you will also tend to get more kind of both the support, both from the volunteers as well as the other levels in which you can attract. So that's the one area which I certainly feel the maybe the time is a constraint where we are able to share what level, how many things that we are using. But it will also good at least an anecdotal level what kind of impact it has created. I think that's going to help you. And the second issue is also in terms of reaching. One is how do we reach within the small level, but the connecting to across the globe, but also engaging with those various other institutions. I think that is also an important. We are not walking in isolation, so connecting with the mainstream media and also with the state and also the various other institutions, and how we are influencing the information that comes. What we say is an evidence-based advocacy. So the data that you are gathering, but how we are also influencing a policy outcome, which normally will have a much more larger impact and reach across the communities. I think that's an area which I'll be certainly looking into that, and I'm sure you will be doing it, but how do we bring that story? And of course, the second element, we also looked into the social commerce. I wish we have more stories to come, because that is an also another area. When we work on the issues of livelihood, the apart from sharing the information, the social commerce is also an excellent area where you can do strengthen the livelihoods of the both the poor from different locations. So I think that's an area which I think certainly we can use and strengthen both across the community and also vis-a-vis with the rest of the market. So those are the broad areas which I certainly feel. The final line which I would also look at is, one, you identify the victim or the people who are discriminated and you will empower them. But it's equally important, how do we reach the other side of the fence? One is in terms of violence against women or girl, so we empower the woman and girl, but at the same time, how we are going to sensitize and engage with the men, boys. I think that's an important. So I think the most challenging part is crossing those boundaries. Those who are not willing to engage, how we are going to engage. I think that's the story will also be quite interesting to know. You must be having a lot of, but any anecdotal, the numbers that will come, it will only inspire and that kind of a momentum could be built in. And the final comment, I'm also purely a little bit come from a human rights background. I started off looking, do you also get any stories related to discrimination based on identity such as caste or ethnicity? I didn't find much. So I think that's also an area which I think we need to explore. How come the issues of discrimination affecting almost close to 200 million is not strongly captured in those? Perhaps whether why they are not inside this this particular room. But that is the thought, the question that I'm leaving to myself and also to the others. Perhaps once the session breaks, I want to hear if you know, come across, please do come and share with me. Thank you.
I would like to start this with, I've been participating in such so use of social media for non-profit initiatives or for social causes for the last 4 years. And it is so encouraging to see how the transformation has happened. I mean, if I go back and look at my experience as an entrepreneur working in digital marketing, and I look at social causes leveraging social media, I see there is a direct correlation. I remember 3 years back when I was sitting in a similar kind of a place, looking at people talking about using social media, the conversation was more about, I've set up a Facebook page, and there are 100 people that have come to my Facebook page, so it is success. I came back next year and I said, well, my Facebook page is growing, we are doing conversations, we are doing engagement, look at this real case study of here is an impact we have caused. Last year it was more about, hey, we are leveraging Facebook, we are leveraging Twitter, we are on Instagram, and you know, we are just about getting there. I'm so excited this year to see that people are talking about much more activities that they are doing. Specifically liked a lot about the Tweetathon and the Editathon and the other activities that are being done in kind of looking at social media as evangelizing. There are two thoughts that I want to leave with here. One thought is, as you look at social media and as you are kind of thinking about how do you leverage it, don't just think about increasing your community sizes, but rather think about which are the various kinds of communities that you are talking to and how do you impact. For example, for a lot of the initiatives that we talked about here, the actual person who is getting the impact may not be on social media. So your audience and your target of being on social media is not to reach out to the person who is actually getting impacted. That person is not there. Your target is to reach out to the community around them. Your target is to reach out to the opinion makers and influencers. So start looking at specific strategic targets that you want to achieve with specific audiences, and then look at social media as an evangelist right off out from there. Some of the presentations had that, but in some of the ones, I think that could be done slightly better. Second is, look at specific campaigns. Look at specifically, I will do this kind of messaging, and I will get this kind of result. I think there is a little bit more that could be done in that space, and I'm sure as social media as evolves to the next level, and as various causes start leveraging it, I'm sure next year when we sit here, we will be seeing both of these impacts in a much bigger way. Thank you.
Thank you, Kapil. I was thinking what to speak on social media usage if the expert is sitting before us, like Kapil, who is a digital marketing expert. But as he said that you have to do some research before using a social media platform. When you are using Facebook, then you have to do some research, like suppose you get 100 likes for your NGO, then you should take a look, in-depth look, like how many of them are women, how many of them are youth. So you can find out, most probably if you're working on women issue, you can actually find out something, like who is your perfect target group. You can then leverage upon that, and you can join those groups where you will see that your target group is related to this particular group. So this is how you can leverage. But you will have to spend some time. Like you'll feel very happy, I have so much of likes, but then you'll have to go through those profiles and you'll have to find out, you'll have to journalize, you have to come to some analysis, who are those people who are liking your efforts. And after that, you'll have to see that has it really come down to what you are actually looking for. Like in all these presentations we have seen, like some of them, their target groups are the funders. And some of them, their target groups are the people who are actually getting impacted by their programs. So like my choice, I wanted to discuss a little bit in detail the Breakthrough and My Choice campaigns. Both are addressing violence against women. But look at the strategy both of them have used. My Choice has come up with this very interesting, recently they came up this ad of Deepika Padukone, and most of the women there are from, most of those women are elite, if you'll see, but at the same time you're working with the rural women of Telangana also. So how do we relate both of them? It's very interesting to study. Like at one point of time your target group is Telangana women, but overall, they're also their target for advocacy. There, they are working for their rights at the field level. But overall, they are running an advocacy campaign for all the women, I guess. So it's interesting to note that in Breakthrough and My Choice, both are addressing the same target group, but with a different strategy. I would like Kapil to throw some light on how these two are a bit different and successful in their own way.
So, from a social media perspective, what happens is, if you are looking at different kinds of audiences, you need to know who you are targeting. How we look at perception management campaigns, really for most causes, if you think about use of social media, it is about perception management. Perception management around the activity that you are doing, or perception management around the cause that you are promoting or cause that you are working on. The first set of community that we look at are people who are actually getting impacted by the activity that you are doing. In case of Breakthrough, that audience is the rural audience. In case of My Choice Foundation, that audience is more of a mature urban audience. So in case of Breakthrough, that audience is not on social media, or very limited amount of that audience will be on social media. In case of My Choice Foundation, a lot of that audience will be on social media. The second part of the community that we look at is community that sits around people that are getting impacted. So for example, if I'm doing a campaign in the rural segment and I'm actually working with slums, or I'm actually working with people at the bottom of the pyramid, they must be laborers in a factory, or they must be working in some home, or they must be working in some office. So that office, that factory, that home, and that community around them is the people who are actually the community that is getting impacted. So not the actual person, but the community that is getting impacted. In case of Breakthrough, the major targeting that needs to be done is for that community. That community should be able to, number one, that community should be able to see the grassroots level difference that is being caused, because they're made, they're peon, people that they associate with, or people that they work with, people that they use in some kind of skills or everything are being impacted there. The third community that we see are the opinion makers, the influencers, the people who are actually making decisions or making opinions. These could be public policy people. These could be other non-profit organizations and causes in the same space. Or these could be digital evangelists, or these could be celebrities or other people. The fourth, and these are very important for all causes, because I very sincerely believe that a fundamental problem that a lot of causes face is not just their ability to reach out to the right audience or get funding, But a fundamental problem that they face, or a fundamental opportunity, let me not use the word problem, a fundamental opportunity that is available is there are so many different NGOs. Even here we saw how many organizations working in women's safety and violence against women and everything. Most of these organizations could do a lot better by collaborating, just by collaborating with each other. And the fourth audience that we look at, fourth and the final audience we look at, is actually the funders and the collaborators. This is where the larger organizations, you know, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, you know, the Climate Foundation, the various much larger organizations, the Bloomberg Foundation, those, and how do you build funding related conversations, or how do you build collaborations with them becomes important. So as you are looking at your specific cause and your specific activity, think about these four audiences differently, and look at the kind of message and the kind of program you would want to run for each one of those differently. And that really will provide most of the success and a much better framework to manage social media.
I think that's been a very interesting and a very helpful insight to all of us here, I'm sure. And I wish we had a little more time, you know, for the panel members to share their views on how you take social to the next level. But I think we have a little paucity of time, and I would like to take some questions from the audience as well. But given the time constraint, we just have time for three questions, and I think I'll follow Gayatri's rule, and we'll have one question from this group, one from this group, and one from this group. Yeah? So, and let's first note down the question, and then we'll get to the answers. So questions, anyone?
Yeah, so you can raise your hands.
Okay, so no questions from this group. This group has any questions? Great. This group has any questions?
Hi. I don't exactly have a question, but it's more of a comment in response to actually what Kapil had to say. Just a clarification that at Breakthrough, we work with all different kinds of groups. So while we work in rural areas, we also work in peri-urban areas. We also work in absolutely urban metropolitan cities as well. And yes, I mean, so it's just not rural areas that we work in. But yes, we do try and see how best we can use different social media tools in all these different kinds of spaces. So in spaces like a rural area, we will try and use, say, an IVR system, which is a social media network in itself, you know. It's just that it's an audio-based social network. We believe that it's a social network. Whereas in spaces like in a peri-urban area, where we might probably use a little bit of WhatsApp, because that's more prevalent there, the youth and all, they use WhatsApp quite a lot. And whereas in urban areas, we use all. We'll use Twitter, we'll use Facebook, we'll use Instagram, we'll Pinterest, anything and everything that, you know, we can lay our hands on. And of course, WhatsApp as well. But yeah, I mean, we agree with, like, you know, at least I agree with what you're trying to say, is that, yes, depending on the kinds of audience that we have, we try and think of different tools that we can use and, you know, reach out to the largest, you know, group of people. Thank you.
Yeah, I'd also just like to make a quick clarification, just because we won't want to take credit for anything that's not ours as well. So Deepika Padukone's video, My Choice, doesn't belong to the My Choices Foundation, although it did launch 2 days after we released our Respect to Protect videos, which featured Virat Kohli and Suresh Raina. Your point is very accurate, though, that we, while our services are provided primarily to women, and at the grassroots level, our social media use and our mass media use is for a very different audience. And we specifically target men, because that's one of our main parts of our ethos, is that we must engage men in the processes, and they're at least 50% of the solution in finding solutions to violence against women. So I just wanted to make that clarification in terms of our target audience, especially for our online campaigns, is men. Has been men and will in the future also be men and boys primarily. Although we do always include women in these also. While you're correct, our services are for women at the sort of grassroots level.
So I think we'll conclude the session now. And just one point I would like to make is we've had very good discussions today and we saw wonderful presentations. you know, but a competition is such that amongst 20 participants, it's not that everyone will get a prize. But then, you know, in my mind, each one of you is a winner here. And just to, you know, give you a brief overview of what we really looked for while selecting the winners, of course, in the evening, Osama will talk more about it. I mean, you know, how you really leverage social, the way we look at it is, you know, we look at 4 or 5 areas, how you progress along the social journey. I think my colleagues here talked very well, you know, about this very thing. Kapil very well talked about, you know, how do you proceed in the journey 3 years back, what social meant and today what it meant was. So the way we looked at the entire thing is we started with the vision. So, you know, as Mr. Praveen Agrawal talked about, that have you defined the vision well? So wherever vision or strategy is well defined and then you try and map social to that, it works out to be a lot more productive and a lot more fruitful. So the way we looked at the entire thing, and what we would recommend that when you are you know going forward on your social journey is the simplest and most straightforward on social path is to communicate what you are doing to your stakeholders, you know, just to make your NGO known to the larger world. That's the simplest and most straightforward thing that can be done, that you just publish what work you are doing. Second, another simpler work is fundraising, crowdsourcing of funds, you know, that so there are enough people ready to donate, and if you're able to communicate your work in the right manner, you're able to raise funds. The third step there, what we see is, you know, where you need volunteers network, where you need people to come and participate, are you able to excite the volunteers to come and join your program? That becomes a third level in that progression. Fourth level that we see out there is that, you know, are you using online to amplify your offline activities? So like what Breakthrough talked about, or, you know, what Wildlife SOS talked about. I mean, Breakthrough has got very interesting campaigns, how they have used Twitter and Facebook to actually amplify their on-field activities. So how you are leveraging that, the blurring of online and offline activities that really takes to the next highest level. And then further, what social changes are you causing? Like, you know, crossing the bridge. If your NGO is about violence against women, are you also able to influence men to change their habits and get into that positive space? That's how we look at the social journey, and we use some of these criteria to actually, you know, identify the winners today. But believe me, each one of you is a winner. We had beautiful presentations today, a lot of learning personally for me, and I'm sure for all of you. And I thank you everyone for being part of this session.
So thank you very much for a wonderful session. So we have some gifts and certificates to give to the presenters. So I'll call out the name one by one, and the organization can come up on stage and collect the certificates and gifts. So the first one is Praveen Lata Sansthan. Breakthrough. Society for Development Activities Project, KALE. Chow Foundation. Wildlife SOS. Wildlife SOS. Turnstone Global. Nidan. Please clap. Thank you very much. India Spend. India spent? Teach for India? Computer Association of Nepal? My Choices Foundation? Accountability Lab? Jharkhand State Livelihood Promotion Society? Bodhi Impact Intervention? Is there anyone who has given the presentation and I haven't called out their name for certificates? Has anyone who gave the presentation they've got the certificates and gifts? Okay, thank you very much. We have some gifts for the panelists also. So, yeah, and there is one for Deepthi also, so probably I should. Okay, thank you very much. So with this, we conclude the session. All the presenters, please come up on stage. We'll gather together for a group photograph. Thank you very much. Panelists, please stay back for 2 minutes because there's something else which has to be, there is one more gift for them. So probably Deepthi can hand over the gift to each panelist.
Oh my God. Thank you.
An extra gift.
Thank you.
Ajit, come talk about it. I'll give you the mic.
Okay. Yeah, let's give that to me. Yeah, this particular little light is actually made by an NGO here, and it's very interesting because there's a solar panel at the back, and it's a solar light. So you just turn it over, it gets charged in the day, and it's about having. It's the program is called One Child, One Light. So you can actually donate it to any number of children in any schools in the rural area. It's supposed to reach a lot of children, so it's just a small gift to kind of remind you that there are children who need light in this country. So please take a look at it. Thank you.